let's go back. Let's go back to like 1978 or something like that, the first time I heard Eruption, when that album came out. I've been a fan of Eddie and his band Van Halen since then. And although I'm not a lead guitar player, Eddie is, I think he's the greatest guitar player of all time. I think a thing that a lot of people overlook, because he is such a great, if not the best lead guitar player ever, he's also an incredible rhythm player. And I've always felt that that's why he's the guy, because he really is truly the complete package. And his tone is ridiculous. From day one, he's had the greatest tone in rock. So unmistakable, you know, like that. It doesn't, in a millisecond, you know it's him. It's the most recognizable tone in rock music, in my opinion. So, you know, when he started making his own line of amps, specifically these EVH ones, there's something about this EVH model, that first one he put out, the white one, I saw that and I was like, I gotta get my hands on that thing. You just knew, there was something about it, even before I heard it, I just knew how good it was gonna sound. And I checked one out, and in me, I had to have it. And then I had to have another one, and this is even before, I was just buying them. I wasn't endorsed or, I was buying them anyway. And I was using them on the records, on our Worship Music record, that EVH-3, one of the white ones, is the main amp on that record, as well as Four All Kings. It's a combination of that and a Randall and one of my old JCM 800s from 82. It's just such an amazing sounding head. I made a decision that I needed to make a change because they just sounded so good. And it's kind of like, why am I not using these things all the time? And then the people at EVH were kind enough to send me one of these 5153Ss with the EL34s in them. And they said, oh, you like what you heard before? Well, wait till you hear this. And it's like it's like Eddie just kind of, imagine like if you had your head in it, he said, oh, come here, give me that thing. Let me, and he just went behind it with a screwdriver and then just kind of like modded it for you personally. That's what this head sounds like to me. I mean, if I ever had my dream amp, well, I have it now, because channel 2 on this head, it sounds like stepping on the gas in like a Dodge Hellcat or like a Harley. It's just, it has that throaty growl, which translated into my guitar tone is just the edgiest, chunkiest, most powerful, just punch. Like, you know, it's like, I've described my tone before, but this comes even closer to it. It's like Bruce Lee's 1-inch punch. That's when I hit that palm mute on an E chord, just chunk like that, and then mute it. It's so powerful, it feels like it would knock you out if you're just, you know, standing in front of it, it'll knock you on your ass. And the EQ on this, the tone, the growl, the clean distortion, because that it's the other thing people, I think, make a big mistake a lot of the times, I think, with metal tones, is they oversaturate and there's too much gain. And my tone has always been about as clean as I could possibly get it, with just the right amount of gain to keep that edge. But I want to hear everything. I want it to sing. And this thing is it's a fucking beast that sings. Like, seriously. Unbelievable. Just crazy. Right in the box. Like, you don't have to do anything to this thing. Nothing. Just plug in. And it's like the sickest sound I've ever heard coming out of an amplifier. So. I was sold instantly, but channel 1 as well, the clean sound also, amazing. You get it as clean as you want, just the richest, cleanest tone, as well as you get a little gain in that channel 1, and just the littlest bit of gain, and totally have an amazing AC/DC Malcolm-esque. I've had a Gretsch plugged in the channel 1, and it sounds ridiculous. So if I do an AC/DC cover band, I don't have to change my amp. And channel 3, which exists, but for me, I have more than enough gain in channel 2 where I don't even have to go to 3, although there are a couple of points in the set I'm starting to realize where I do little things. I have little solo bits or tremolo parts where I might start having Armando change to channel 3 for those, just so I get a a bit more sustain. Like, I do the tremolo solo at the top of Madhouse, and I'm feeling like I need more gain on it. So instead of changing the gain in my rhythm tone, we'll just switch to channel 3 for the lead sound. These amps are very roadworthy. There might be other amps that I'm not going to name names that they may sound great in a studio, but they're not amps that you're going to take on tour because they're just not built for living in a truck and, you know, traveling all around the world and basically taking that abuse, you know, months and months and months and months and months for years. They probably would break down a lot more. But like I said, these are beasts. I've got my rig here in the States, and I've got a duplicate rig like this over in Europe, and that's it. I don't think I'll, unless he makes an amp that sounds better than this, that's it. I found the one. I would love, even if it's just for me, and I already has the Frankenstein pattern, why not do one in red and black? Come on, where is it? Limited edition. Come on, it's money in the bank.